Hey everyone, Zarafan here, welcome back to my channel and to another EXOS Heroes video. This time I want to share with all of you what is going to be my take on the director's note for season 4 Fallen Sky, because it can be overwhelming. Now, don't worry, this is not going to be a word by word reading, but more like taking the important features I saw that are relevant, at least for me as a free-to-play player. So Fallen Sky's update is going to pick up where the last season actually left. Spoiler alert, in case you are not there, be careful about this, but basically the guys from Pedas came in and joined the team, and then we reach into the new hero class. This is going to be after Faded, I guess. Her name is Misty, and from what the world community is actually understanding on the patch, you know, is that this has some paywalls ahead. The way you recruit this hero is going to take more effort, more resources. Cess is not useful here. There are going to be many other ways that you have to go through in order to get her. So far what I feel is the best take for this issue, this new feature, this new recruitment system, is to save your tickets in the same way you will do at some point for nation recruit tickets. Wait till you can actually pity her. For this, we still have to wait till it'll arrive, because we may be losing some information on the translation. Now, with this new recruitment, we also have the mythic challenges, which work like the monthly challenges, I guess, or like a raid pass or whatever. I'm gonna guess this is the main place where we are going to get the mythic recruitment tickets that we need. We still need to see if through these missions we are going to be able to get all the tickets needed to complete that recruitment. That's the way we will ensure that those recruitment, those new recruitment are actually like possible for free-to-play players. We still have to see once this is implemented how free-to-play friendly this is. Because my impression, or at least my expectation online games about this, is that if you are concurrent, if you daily log in and do all those challenges, then you should be rewarded with all the tickets you need daily basis to get through all the 280 pulls you have to in order to get into Pity to claim the reward of that mythic hero. That's my expectation. We still don't know, but we will see. So what is my take on this string of creation? It's not the same as all the previous string of creation, or like I said on my previous video. You see, the value inside this, like the value you get from your cess invested in this, is so great that you should consider a few things. You are getting 3 generals. Believe it or not, those 3 generals are more important than those 3 fate core, golden fate core units. Because the fate core can only like upgrade so much after the first fusion. However, the general is going to boost not only the unit, but also the world region. You're getting 3 faded, 3 fate core, golden fate core, that you can then go into Door of Creation and exchange that to see if you get any new golden fate core that you do not have, or more, maybe a blue fate core. You will also get one, from what I understand of that picture they did post, one of each faded unit. That's great, especially for the scout system, because as you can see, it says step 1 is going to be 50%. I'm going to guess that is 50% the cost, because if you take a look on the bottom where you have to pay the 700 cess, it says 350. Now, if that's the case, imagine getting the 3 generals inside the first steps with only 50% of those steps. I don't know how many pulls is that going to be, 6? I don't remember how many pulls you need for a wall SOC, but we're gonna see. But just imagine getting the 3 faded gold unit and the generals inside step 1 or maybe step 2. That's a lot of cess you're saving. Now, about the way they are like expanding the complexity of the signature force feature, I have not much comment, especially because as a free-to-play player, I don't have enough resources to move forward, you know? I'm still struggling, and like I said before, I am even considering to get into SOC just to get 3 generals. So from that point where I stand right now, trying to have a comment on something that is definitely an endgame feature is not going to give you guys any kind of value, you know? So now the rank 2 equipment is a feature that it went into the direction I was not expecting. Now rank items equipment is going to be like an evolution of your current item, which is nice, because if you did invest a lot of Star of Fate on certain equipments to get the boost you needed, the item is going to reset on the level but not on the combat power and main attribute, and you're going to still keep this enhancement, the magic enhancement with the Star of Fate. That's what I believe, that's what I understand. Let me know in the comment section below if I am wrong in any of this. So yeah guys, these were the topics I wanted to talk about on the new patch notes from the directors of the Season 4 Fallen Guide. There is obviously a lot of expectation from all the community on this season. Me personally, I'm trying to look forward into new content that is more active, more tactical, more online, more, you know, that encourage players to play the game and not just to keep the AFK content alive. I really want to do something with another player, either Arc Boros or any kind of content that keep me doing something. If you think I did miss something important in this patch note, especially for a free-to-play player or for any new player joining the game and watching this video, let me know in the comment section down below. This is all for now guys, see you guys in the next one.